Auto 060. Estamos llegando al final de este show de esta semana. Ha sido muy interesante y muy emocionante todas las cosas que hemos hecho. El Top 10 List de los mejores autos familiares del 2013, la prueba de manejo del BMW M6 allá en Austin, Texas, y las experiencias aquí en Lamborghini Miami. And now we're going to switch back to English again because we have Chu Hee Lee, Deputy Director of Volkswagen Group Electronics Research Laboratory in Silicon Valley, in California. How are you, Chu Hee Lee?
I'm doing very well.
Thank you. Good. Thank you. Thank you for having taking the time to talk to us. And I understand there was a big announcement recently regarding your partnership with Stanford University, right?
Yes. So we have been working with Stanford for quite some time, and this marks our extension of the existing collaboration that we've been working on.
Yeah, and it's pretty amazing how much technology has moved in the auto industry pretty quickly, right? I guess in the past 5 years almost, I mean, which for the auto industry, for other industries might be a long time, but for the auto industry it's pretty short time because usually it takes about that time just to develop one car, and there's so much technology that has come out in cars in that period, five years.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, the automotive industry, compared to the consumer electronics, the development time and testing takes much longer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and tell us a little bit about what the work that is done at the lab, the Volkswagen lab there in Silicon Valley. I know that you had a project recently, a few years ago actually, with a fully autonomous Volkswagen Touareg. So that was one of the things that you've done there, but can you share what you're doing? With our audience?
Absolutely. So you know, the lab, we've been working on research project like this autonomous driving vehicle, like the Touareg, the Stanley, for the in 2005 Grand Challenge, and we also worked on a Passat 2 years later for the urban autonomous driving, and also with the PaxPeak TTS and now the TTS to go autonomously on top of the PaxPeak in Colorado, and we continue our work on the autonomous driving. So that's one topic. Another topic is in the domain of infotainment. Our lab made the first prototype of the Google Earth on the our infotainment system, and then we have that as a product. Today you go to any Audi dealer and you can buy an Audi with Audi Connect system, which includes the Google Earth navigation, that where you can see gorgeous satellite images in your map.
Yeah, that's replacing the images from all the GPS system with what you see in your computer, right, or your smartphone.
Well, I would say it's more kind of overlay. So we still have our standard map on board. So in case that you don't have connectivity because you're in a very remote place,
okay,
you still have like standard map. And then we extended the standard map by including the Google Earth to download the satellite images that you were familiar with from your desktop or from smartphone, so that it gives you a better idea of your surrounding by seeing the satellite photos.
Yeah, so you have both systems there. But can we go a little bit, can we go back a little bit to talk about the autonomous driving cars? I mean, obviously you have proven the theory, but where do you see this technology being applied in the general market? I know we're some time from that, but what do you see the challenges in that?
So some of the, let's say early implementation of autonomous driving will be under certain conditions, like autonomous driving mode to follow a stop and go traffic. Autonomous maybe driving, like autonomous parking would be the some of the relatively earlier deployment of like partially autonomous, or we call it automatic driving. And for the full like autonomous driving, it will take a little bit longer than just say partial automotive autonomous driving.
Yeah, and that, I mean, as I said, the technology is already there, but there's also maybe the governments, the city government, that have to put the infrastructure for this, all this to happen.
Yeah, it'll be also a lot of this, the liability and some of the legal issues. If the cars are like fully autonomous, then, you know, for example, when there's an accident, that would be kind of interesting then, you know, like, you know, like, who is responsible for, you know, a certain thing. So we want to have the driver always be engaged, even though the car's in autonomous mode. However, it also brings a very interesting question of the interface that we need to have in the car to engage the driver from the autonomous mode and transition to, let's say, to the manual mode.
Yeah. We're talking with Chohei Lee, Deputy Director of the Volkswagen Lab in Silicon Valley, where all the, I was going to say the magic, but there's no magic in your work. There's like hard work, right? A lot of science behind it. So what other projects are going to be involved with now that we're working, or you extended your partnership with the Stanford University?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So we're looking at this, the future vehicle of, you know, we call it connected intelligent car. The car knows about the driver much more, and car knows about your driving context. So it's not that we only know about how you drive, but we want to know, like, you know, the purpose of your trip. Is your trip, you know, for, let's say, business? I mean, are you running late to a very important meeting? This type of, you know, the context of the drive becomes quite relevant, you know, for the vehicle to provide, you know, right information at the right time for you. Right, so that we want to make the car more intelligent. Your smartphone today knows a lot about you and the context because it has a lot of your like information, contact, and the calendar, and so on. And we want to make the car to be, you know, intelligent to work with other intelligent systems like this, the smart like apps and you know, smart appliances and any other like intelligence that you might find in your digital life.
Yeah, it's really amazing what we were just talking about, because I mean, just about what, before the iPhone, really, like 5-6 years ago, you could have never imagined these kind of things in a car.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah, and then you're also getting used to more and more of with the power of the smartphone. There's like a lot of apps that simplifies your digital life, right? There's things like Evernote that can make really easy for you to take the note and share, and then there's you know, social media like, you know, Facebook, where you're sharing so much of your information and data, and there's like, you know, Google that also knows like things that you're searching for and making recommendations. Even, you know, go to Netflix and is trying to make a recommendation of the movie that you might like. So there's a lot of intelligence being built around our digital life, and we want to have the vehicle as intelligent as possible to interact, you know, with other intelligence that you're kind of, you know, interacting in your life outside of the vehicle. So the car will be fully part of your, you know, connected digital lifestyle.
Yeah, Chohei. So the we're running out of time, unfortunately. But do you have a web page where our audience can follow all the work for the Volkswagen Electronics Research Lab that maybe we can share with them?
Absolutely. Yeah, our homepage is www.dwerl.com. So dwerl.com, and you can find some more information about, you know, our you know, past work and also our, you know, current work in there.
Excellent. Thank you very much for your time, and really fascinating things that are going on there. And hopefully we'll visit you at the lab over there, and maybe we can see some of those magic things that are happening in the cars. Again, I said magic, and it's all the science. I'm sorry. All the science that go into the cars.
I'd be more than happy to host you here, and thank you very much for having me in your show.
Thank you very much. Chohei Lee, Deputy Director of the Volkswagen Group Electronics Research Lab in Silicon Valley, in California. Y bueno, ahí tenía la entrevista sobre todas las cosas increíbles que están pasando con los coches. Hablaba de él, de cómo el auto se va a convertir en una extensión de nuestros teléfonos celulares. En realidad, antes nos conformábamos con eso nada más, con el teléfono. Bueno, esto ha sido la edición de hoy de Auto 060. Gracias a DJ Kafa y en los controles. Y nos escuchamos muy pronto en la siguiente edición aquí en Cristina Radio Network. Esto es Auto 060. Yo soy Javier Moto.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.